हेलो गाइस, आई एम तेजपाल पारशिवनीकर, प्रेजेंटली वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट इन GH रायसन एकेडमी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ मैकेनिज्म. वी नो दैट द मशीन इज जनरली डेवलप फ्रॉम द मैकेनिज्म. सो मशीन आर सच अ डिवाइस विच रिसीव सम अवेलेबल फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इन टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू सम यूजफुल वर्क. For example, if we take the example of a ceiling fan, the ceiling fan consists of a vertical rod which is fixed with the ceiling, and the second part is a disc which contains three more blades. So this machine is converting the electrical energy into the wind energy, and our requirement is to obtain wind energy. So this is a kind of machine. So generally machine consists of number of parts. So we will further discuss about the various terminologies present in machine. So first terminology is the about single part, that is kinematic link. Since most of the parts are in moving condition, so we call all terminology, we refer all terminology with the help of word kinematics. So we will discuss about the kinematic link. So each part of the machine which have some relative motion with respect to some other part, that is called as the kinematic link or element or member. This kinematic link may consist of other several parts also, but they do not have any relative motion between them. That is, all other parts are rigidly fastened together so that they will form a single link. This link is further classified in three more categories depending on their properties. So basically these are three types. One is a rigid link, second is flexible link, and third one is fluid link. This rigid link does not undergo any deformation during its transmission of motion. For example, if we consider the same ceiling fan example, so in ceiling fan the vertical rod is fixed, it doesn't get deformed, and even the three blades and circular disc doesn't get any deformation. So we can call this, thus this part are rigid parts, so this is a rigid link. Second one is a flexible link. So in flexible link the deformation undergoes, the link undergoes partly deformation. That is, for example, if we take the example of belts, chains, ropes, wires, these are get deformed during the transmission of a motion. Third classification is about the fluidized link. Our intention of making a link is that it should transfer the required kind of motion. That is, the link need not to be a rigid body, but it must be a but it must be a resistance body. That is, it must be capable of transforming the required motion. So link may be in the form of fluid also. So for example, in hydraulic brakes, in hydraulic chain, in hydraulic jacks, the pressure of a fluid will create a force on the piston inside the cylinder. So hydraulic fluid will also act as the one of the link. The links are further have different types. Maybe it binary link or ternary link or quaternary link, depending on the number of free nodes, free point available on that particular link. If we consider a simple link that is in the form of rod, if this is a rigid link, if this link contains two nodes, it means that two different links may get attached on these two different points. So this is the example of binary link. If we consider three different node available on the link, that is three different links are get attached on that three different point, so we can say that this is a ternary link. And similarly, there is a quaternary link where there are four nodes, four different points where some other links are get attached. So this is about the kinematic link, single part of the machine. Now we further go, if there are two parts, the chain, that is the system, is known as kinematic pair. If there are two parts and if one part is more relative to some other part, relative to second part, then we can say that this will form a kinematic pair. For example, same example, the ceiling fan, if we take, first one is vertical rod which is fixed and second part is disc along with three blades. So this is a example of kinematic pair. It contains two links. So there are further classification of kinematic pair depending on the various criteria. first part is depending on the type of motion that we are getting from the kinematic pair, from getting from the two parts of a machine. The first part is, first type of kinematic pair is called as the completely constrained motion. If the motion obtained from the kinematic pair is completely constant, if we are getting the required kind of motion, then we can say that this is the type of completely constrained motion. Second part is incompletely constrained motion. If we take the example of a circular rod present in a circular hole, so there is a sliding motion of a rod inside the hole, as well as this rod will get torn through 90 degree. So there are two kind of motion, and our intention is to get only turning motion, not a sliding motion. So when we are getting two different kind of motion, but our requirement is to get only one type of motion, so this is a example of incompletely constrained motion, means we are getting the motion in more than one direction. Third part is successfully constrained motion, where we are getting two kind of motion, but one kind of motion we are removing with the help of some external force. The same example is the circular rod and the circular hole. If we want to prevent the sliding motion of a rod, then we need to consider the two collars present at the two end of the shaft, so that the shaft doesn't move inside the rod, it will only get turned. So this is the kind of successfully constrained motion, where we are preventing the sliding motion of the rod with the help of this collar attaching on the two ends of the rod. The second classification is about the type of motion, type of relative motion present between the two parts of a kinematic pair. First is a sliding pair. First sliding pair, where if the two links are connected in such a way that there is only sliding motion between the link, then we can say that this is an example of sliding pair. For example, if we take the example of petrol engine, IC engine, this IC engine contains a particular mechanism. Just below the tank, petrol tank, we have a combustion chamber where the cylinder is present. Inside the cylinder, there is a piston. If we draw a simple line diagram of that particular mechanism, so there is a cylinder, outside a cylinder, and this is the cross section of the cylinder, and this is the piston. This piston is further connected with the connecting rod. This connecting rod is further connected with the crank, and this crank is capable of moving around 360 degree with the help of this crankshaft. So in this case, the piston is continuously reciprocating within the cylinder. So there is a sliding motion of the piston within the cylinder. So this is a kind of a sliding pair. The second type is turning pair, when two links are connected in such a way that there is a turning moment between the link. For example, same, the shaft, a circular shaft fitted in a circular hole, so this shaft will turn about 360 degrees, so this is a kind of turning motion. Third type is the screw pair, where there is a moment of one part with respect to some other part with the help of a screw thread. For example, in nut and bolt, the nut is moving on the bolt with the help of the screw thread provided on the surface of the bolt. Fourth part is a spherical pair. In that spherical pair, this one part is capable of moving around 360 degree. We can say that this is turning or swelling about the whole direction. For example, in ball and socket joint, even in case of attachment of a mirror, we can move the mirror in different direction. So these are the classification types of kinematic pair based on the relative motion. The second classification is based on the type of contact between the pair, between the number of element present in a pair. If there is a surface contact, when two links of a element, for example, the piston and this connecting rod are connected at this point with the help of pin. So if there is a surface contact between two parts, then we can say that this is a lower pair, surface contact, lower pair. And if there is a line or a point contact between the element, then we can say that this will form a higher pair. So depending on the type of contact, nature of surface contact or line or point contact, it will be classified into in the form of higher pair or lower pair. And further, last classification of kinematic pair is that the pair may be a self-closed pair or pair may be a force-closed pair. In self-closed pair, the two links are automatically mechanically connected with each other. For example, in this pin joint, there is a socket and there is a pin. So pin will automatically connected in the socket. So all pin joint forms a self-closed pair. Whereas in force-closed pair, two links are forcefully connected together so that they have some relative motion, the required kind of relative motion along the force transmission or during the transmission of the motion. For example, in cam and follower, the follower link is attached with the cam with the help of either spring force or with the help of gravity force. So this classifications is about the kinematic pair. First terminology is kinematic link, second terminology is kinematic pair, and then third terminology comes that this is a kinematic chain. So when there are number of kinematic pairs connected in such a way that the first link is joined with the lost link, then we can say that this will form a kinematic pair. For example, this is a slider crank mechanism which is present in the two-stroke engine. This cylinder, outer cylinder, is fixed. Piston is moving or sliding along the cylinder. The motion obtained from the piston, it transferred to the connecting rod, and then further it transferred to the crank. So this crank, this reciprocating movement of the piston, is converted into the rotary motion of the crank. So this is a machine where the reciprocating motion is converted into the rotary motion. So here, the if we consider the number of parts, number of links. So first link, cylinder, is fixed. Second link, piston. Third link, connecting rod. Fourth link, crank. And again, fifth link is fixed. So cylinder is fixed as well as this crankshaft is fixed. So this fixed link will form a single link. That means the first, second, third, fourth, and further one, all are connected in chain. So we can say that this is a kinematic chain. And next terminology comes that mechanism. When this kinematic chain, when one of the part of this kinematic chain is fixed, then we can say that this is a mechanism. In every machine, in every mechanism, there is a one part which is fixed. In this diagram, in this mechanism, the cylinder is fixed and the crankshaft is fixed. So there is always a fixed link, whether it is a mechanism, whether it is a machine. And then finally, the terminology of machine comes that when this mechanism is used for converting some available energy, input motion, into some output work, then it is called as a machine. So the development of machine comes from various terminologies, like first is kinematic link, then kinematic pair, single part, two parts, then multiple parts, that is kinematic chain. Then one of the link of a kinematic chain is fixed, then mechanism is developed, and then when mechanism is used for converting some input to output motion, then that will called as the machine. There is again some terminologies that we are using in a mechanism, that is the next terminologies is structure. In structure, there are again a multiple links, but there is no relative motion at all between the links. In this case, there is a motion between piston and cylinder, then between a connecting rod and a crank. There are continuous motion along the link, but in case of structure, there is no motion at all. So this structure is used for transforming the forces only, whereas in machine, this mechanism or machine is used for transforming motion of various parts. So structure contains no motion transmission, only force transmission. So application of this structure in railway bridges are made up of structure, even roof truss. So these are the example where structure is used. The mechanism, we will talk more about the mechanism. The mechanism is identified with the help of some again next terminology. The next terminology is about the degree of freedom. The degree of freedom is a number which will identify that whether this mechanism has 0 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree. So identification of mechanism is takes place with the help of its number, and this number is called as degree of freedom. So degree of freedom is the number of, for particular mechanism, it is a number of independent input parameters required to specify the position or configuration of various links available in that mechanism. For example, if we take a simple mechanism, let's say this is a fixed link, two nodes, then second there is a crank, third there is a connecting rod, and fourth there is output link. This chain, link number 1, 2, 3 and 4, there are 4 links. So we can say that this is a 4 bar mechanism or 4 link mechanism. In this, there is a link number 1 which is fixed. So we can say that this is a mechanism, and this will be a machine when the one of the link, let's say link number 2, if the link number 2 we are giving some motion, that is let's say rotary motion, we are giving rotary motion to link number 2. So if we are supplying the rotary motion as input motion and we are obtaining some output from link number 4, so this will then form a machine. So the for particular mechanism or machine, there is a number degree of freedom. So if you want to find the degree of freedom of that particular mechanism, so there is a criteria, that is Kurzbach criteria, which will give that the this mechanism possesses how many degree of freedom. So Kurzbach criteria is given by one formula. For example, this is for 3 into n minus 1 minus 2j minus h. This is the formula of Kurzbach criteria. With the help of this formula, we can find out the degree of freedom of any mechanism. Here, the f represents the degree of freedom of mechanism, and small n is representing the number of links available in mechanism. Small j, number of joints, we can say that this is a number of lower pair also, and h stands for the number of higher pair. So n for this 4 bar mechanism, n number of links, so here there are 1 2 3 4 links, so value of n is equal to 4. If we consider j value, that is number of lower pair, so this is a joint, means joint between link number 1 and 2, this is a joint. Let's say this is point A joint, first joint, then between 2 and 3 this is second joint, between link 3 and 4 this is third joint, between link 4 and 1 this is fourth joint. So there are total fourth joint, and if we count the number of lower pair, then A, B, C and D all are a pin joint, and we know that the pin joint has a lower pair, has a surface contact. So the value of J for this 4 bar mechanism, 1, 2, 3, 4, number of lower pair is 4, and then the number of higher pair, all are pin joints, so there is no line contact or point contact between the various links. So here the value of H is 0. So from this, if we put this value on this formula, so we will get F is equal to 3 into n minus 1, 3 into 3, 4, 3 into 3, 9, minus 2 into 4 in minus 0. So this is equal to 9 minus 8, this is 1. So this number 1 represents the degree of freedom of this 4 bar mechanism. So there are again lots of mechanism where we will find out the degree of freedom of different mechanism. Even some mechanism contains a higher pair, that is line or point contact. We already discussed about the cam and follower mechanism where there is a line or point contact. So here the value of H comes into existence. So this is all about degree of freedom. Then there is a further topic, that is the inversion of mechanism. The inversion of mechanism, we can define that the method of obtaining different mechanism by fixing different links of a kinematic chain, then this process is known as the inversion of a mechanism. For example, in this 4 bar chain, link number 1 is fixed, so we will get some other mechanism where we are supplying input to link number 2 and we are getting output from link number 4. Second case, if the link number 2 is fixed, then we need to supply input to link number 3 and we will obtain the output from link number 4. So depending on the length of a link, number of link, we will obtain different mechanism from a particular set of a mechanism. So basically there are three different types of chain. First is like a four bar chain, quadric cycle chain we can say. Second is single slider crank chain, and third is double slider crank chain. So from four bar chain we will determine, we will form a three different mechanism. First one is beam engine, second is coupling rod of locomotive, and third is the pendulum pump. So in this mechanism, in this chain, the in case of beam mechanism, in case of a beam mechanism, we are converting the rotary motion into the reciprocating motion of the parts. So this is this mechanism is used in like a rotary compressor. Then the second mechanism, coupling rod of locomotive. In that coupling rod of locomotive, we are using this mechanism in railway engine, where the rotary motion is converted into rotary motion. In that case, the length of input link and length of output link need to be same, so that rotary motion is converted into rotary motion. So there are more mechanism that develop from the various kinematics chain. So in next topic, next lecture, we will discuss more about the inversion of various other kinematic chain. Then there are some more mechanism like gear mechanism, cam and follower mechanism. So in next topic, in next lecture, we will discuss more about this.